All right, welcome everybody to the Radius Lab. Now, we've done authentication labs before, or security labs, where we used either standard, extended, or main ACLs. Now we're gonna use Radius. Now, I've done Radius before, but this is a very basic Radius, and we'll continue later on to grow this Radius lab, make it, you know, different types of authentication. But Radius is extremely important because that is one way that we use to authenticate first before we can gain access to the network. All right, so let's go ahead and configure the Radius server. Now, as far as your CCNA, it's in your books. Will they ask you about Radius? No, that is an authentication server. Knows that it creates a database that you need to authenticate first to the Radius server before you gain access to the network. But as far as you configuring Radius or anything like that, that might not happen. May happen in the new one, in the new certification, where, and I will be doing labs for that one, okay? But because that will include CCNA security, because remember, I took all those CCNAs into one. But for the CCNA 200-125, highly unlikely. Okay, but in case they do, you'll know what's going on. So the first thing is, we see here we have the 192.168.1.0 network. So let's apply static IP addresses. Obviously, this is going to be our Radius server, so let's name it that. All right, so this is going to be let's put in caps, Radius. This will be our Radius server. All right, and then let's put the IP address for our Radius server. We're going to go here, go there, and go 192.168.1. Okay. Wow. Brain matter really going back. 1.1 tab. And our gateway will be 192.168.1.254. All right. Always use the last available. All right. And since we're here, well, let's put the IP addresses first, and we'll come back to this. All right. So that was 1.1. So PC0 will be 1.2, 192.168.1.2, tab, 192.168.1.254, okay, and then PC1, and 192.168.1.3, tab, 192.168.1.254, okay, and this is 1.4. 192.168.1.4, tab, 192.168.1.254. Okay, now this is still red, obviously, because I haven't configured the gateway address for that, but I will eventually. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna look at our Radius server here, all right? See, the packet tracer is pretty good. It has its issues, which we all know of, okay? But we're gonna go ahead and see what we can do here, right? We go to sources, you can see there's many things here, like, you know, DHCP, version 6, TFTP, which I've used in the past, DNS, which I've used a lot, syslog, and this is what we're looking for, AAA authentication, which we can use Radius or TACACS. We can use either or. We can use Radius, all right? Now it's off, so we're gonna turn it on. We'll leave the default port of 1645, that's fine. All right, now the client, who is the client? Well, the client is going to be router one. That's going to be the actual, what we're going to be looking at. R1. And then the client IP address is going to be 192.168.1.254. Now you know this. You need to know your network, obviously, in the IP addressing scheme and all that stuff, and already have things in your mind written down. What it is that you're gonna have. I do. I always write things down before I get anything done because my brain goes haywire. Okay, so, and for the secret that it's gonna share, because we're gonna configure the router now for a very basic authentication, okay, for telnetting. All right, this is what it's gonna be. In order to telnet, instead of creating that access list that we always did, that I've shown you how to do a standard access list that will permit or deny telnet, well, we can create this Radius server to do that for us as well. All right. So we're going to do, the secret will be Spartacus. If you haven't watched this movie, you don't know what you're missing. All right. So we add that to that. You can see I already have some names that I created on here. All right. I wonder who these people are. All right. So you see you have a username. D Diaz is Cisco 1. L Diaz, me, is Cisco. And another user, S Ray, Cisco 2. Cool. So these are the people that are in this database right now that are allowed to authenticate to the Radius server in order to get access to the network or to Telnet, which is what our purpose is. So we're just going to minimize this. We're going to go to the router. Ooh, let me make sure it's on the screen so you guys can see. All right. Bring this all the way up here. I think you'll be able to see that. Enable config T hosting R1. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is enable AAA authentication. So we're going to go, and it's there. If you look at it, here it is right here. Authentication, authorization, and accounting. That's what it is. Okay, that's what it is. So we're going to do, let's break this control C. There we go. We're going to do AAA. And what can you do here? All right, we're going to do a new one. Oh, okay, new model. What else? Okay, that's it. Awesome. What are we going to be using this new model for? Authentication. Oh, okay. So we just do AAA authent. Okay. There's a lot of AU. So we're going to do AU authentication. Yes, I tab a lot. I know. And we're going to do login. Well, let me question mark so you can see. You can do many things here. You can do enable, all right? So authentication list for, when you type enable, right? Login, it's gonna set list for all logins, all right? You're gonna decide which type of login, or you can do PPP, all right? At least here in the packet trace. Obviously, in a real iOS, you'll be able to do a lot more things than just that, okay? So we're gonna do it for login. And now you can give it default, which is the default authentication list. Do we want to do that, or do we want to be specific and give it a named list? So we're going to do default. We're actually going to tell it, okay, none, because you can create a group here, default group actually, and we're going to say none, default group, okay. And then it's going to ask you for radius, because that's what we're doing. Okay, and we're going to say none. All right, because we don't want to use the default group. We want to create our own. So when we do this, I'm going to up arrow, so I don't have to retype everything. All right, we're going to get to this point right here. And then we're actually going to give it a name. All right, and our name is going to be telnet underscore lines. Okay. Telnet underscore lines. Okay. And then what is it that you want to do? Okay. That's going to be the group. Okay. And the group will be radius, because that's what we're using. Boom. Okay. And then is there anything else? No, I can just hit CR at that point. All right. Cool. So we have we turned on the AAA authentication, the new model. We went ahead and we didn't want to use the default login group. So we said none, and we created our own group, which is telnet underscore lines. Okay. Now I need to tell it who the Radius server is. Okay. Let's see here. And you can see it right there. All right. So all you gotta just do is tell it, hey, who this Radius service is, okay, and the authentication port that you're using, which is going to be what? 1645, right? That's the default authentication server, right? So it's going to be this particular, it's going to be R1. There's your client IP, okay? But that's the router. So the radio server is pointing to the router. The router has a point to the radio server, which is 1, right? 1.1. So you got to give that IP address. But again, 1645 is the default port number, okay? And then the key, which I think we already typed in. And it's case sensitive, so you got to make sure that you type it correctly, okay? All right, so we're going here. We go radius, server. What about the radius server? Well, radius server, let's say, we'll do the host, okay? It's 192.168. What was it? 1.1? Wow. Okay, authentication. Oh, let me go back. Here you go. Authentication port. That's going to be 1645. What else? The key. Well, what's the key? It is Spartacus. Then, let me check. I always forget something. All right. So we went ahead and we did the new model. Okay. We did it for authentication. We did not using the default radius group. We're using our own, which we called Telnet lines. Okay. So this is important now. This is the actual group that we need to point to. Okay. So now, and then we gave it the port, right? We gave it the IP address of the radio server, and we gave it the port number that we're using and the key. So three key elements here. All right, now this is for Telnet purposes. So where do we go? Line VTY, 0 space, I'm gonna use all available lines. And now we need to go ahead and, you know how I always type login? Look, login, authentication, and then not here is where we put that word. Not the default that we said none to, but the actual word that we, the Telnet lines. Okay. Telnet lines. Cool. Do WR. Now remember, you can't do WR when you're doing this. You have to go back to privilege modes and copy on start. Not that you're going to be configuring this in the CCNA 200.25. I doubt that. Seriously. All right. Click the wrong thing there. All right. So click on VR. Control Z. That should be good to go. So, I didn't put the IP address of the router. That's not good to go. Config D. Interface. What is it? F00. Yeah. Okay. F0/0. IP address 192.168.1.254.255.255.255.0. No shit. Okay, cool. So let's see. Now you see here, I didn't create any username, but look at the start real quick. You can see here, AAA new model. Triple authentication, login Telnet lines group radius. Triple authentication, login default group for radius. No default group, okay? We're using our own Telnet lines. All right, and then go down. There's the IP address, cool. There's a radius server. We're pointing to the 1.1. What authentication port is 1645 and the key is Spartacus. I want to make sure that matches, okay? And then here we have the Telnet lines, which is the group that we created, right? On all the Telnet lines. So that should be good. That should work. All right. So let's go PC2 and let's try a Telnet. All right. So we're going to Telnet, yeah. 192.168.1.254. All right, now username. All right, Al Diaz. And it should be just Cisco, C-I-S-C-O. Now, I'm not saying this is the most speediest thing in the world. It takes a little bit of time. There you go. It's not the speediest thing in the world. All right. And then obviously I didn't set up anything here. All right. So I didn't set up any passwords, but just so you can see that it verified. Now I'm going to exit out of here. And I'm just going to type something silly. I'll say, oh, Telnet, right? Username, Bob. Password, C-I-S-C-O. Login invalid. Right away, right? Because Bob does not exist. Okay? But let's say another computer. Let's test it from another computer. Let's say PC0. All right? And we Telnet. Let's try one of the other usernames. All right? 192.168.1.254, and we'll do D Diaz, and I think that's Cisco 1, CISCO 1, and I'm in. Okay, that is because they're in that radius database. Okay, that radius database right here. All right. So you can go ahead and tell them. So you can use a standard access list, right? Permit that network or a particular host or a particular range of hosts, okay? That you can go ahead and, it all depends on the wildcard mask you use, that will be allowed to go ahead and go into, to tell that into your router, okay? Standard, or you can use an extended if you want. Or name, it's going to be extended or standard, doesn't really matter, but you can also use a radius server, which is nice because you first authenticate to the radius, you have more control, you authenticate to the radius server, and then you gain access. You see, I didn't create any usernames on the router at all. It was just AAA authentication, right? And we created our own specific group called Telnet Lines. You can do it for PvP, like you saw. You can do it, or if you do the default group, it's gonna do it for everything, for, you know, the VTY lines, the console, everything. Okay, it's gonna do it for all that. So we didn't want that. We just wanted to do specific things. So this is, we did it specifically for Telnet, but that's not, doesn't stop you there, because you can do it for wireless, for all these things. If you really want to secure your network, one of the many layers of things that you can do is use a radius server on your network. And as easy as that. And you can go ahead and practice right on the packet tracer. No big deal. All right. And there's your radius server. I'll see you in the next one.